On today's video, we've got another biggin' for the bench. We've got AMT's 125th scale Frua 40-foot exterior post van. The names on some of these kits are just getting longer and longer. They put it all completely in the description. You can see this one can be done up in the Dorn livery. It is a pretty cool kit. I like doing these tractor trailer kits. They're pretty awesome. This one's got the Select-A-Point rear axle on it. It's got some cool, check out all the rigs they offer on that box art there. All the different haulers you can pick up. They got the Bison, the Titan, the Peterbilt 359. It's going to give you some of the details of the trailer. We've got all 8 tire and wheel package. It's got opening doors in the back. You can do it with raised or lowered landing gear. And again, it's got the full tandem suspension on there. So let's start taking a look. That's in the box when you get yours. First up will be Attack of the Chrome on a work trailer kit. Yes, I always talk about this. This is just the way they did it in the old days. So it's always labeled to have this be chrome. We've got some of our brake components here, because we often see completely chrome air brake components on work trailers on the highway. And then we've got some wheel trim rings and the taillights. Now what I'll do is just attach all this stuff and paint right over the chrome with primer and go from there. But you can decide how you want to do it. It does look nice on the truck with those chrome outer rings. So we're not going to say it doesn't look nice. I just don't expect to see that stuff on a work truck that I see around my area. So I always cover it up. 2 steel axles in the kit. These kits end up being quite heavy. And the steel axles are pretty much required to keep it from having any warpage or from your wheels eventually turning in under the weight of a plastic axle. We've got, speaking of the wheels, we've got the tires right here. These are Goodyear tires. Unlike the Firestones we usually see, we can see Goodyear branding, size, and everything on that mold. It's got a shallow tread pattern, so be prepared when you sand that. And on both sides, Goodyear's all around there with the diamonds all around the outside. Those look great. You will get a complete set of 8 of those in the kit. Let's pull up the other equipment in here. We've got a set, though. Show you this when we're actually hooking it up in the kit for the rear brakes and stuff. This is a very, very flexible, wet noodle style rubber tubing instead of that hard vinyl they used to use. And then we've got the red and yellow marker lights in the transparent styrene. What else we got going on the side here? We've got a beautiful decal sheet with the Dorn livery. We can even see it in white here. Dorn says the exact same thing as these, and this lettering here in the white, we've got company information. It says Dorn Transfer Company. It's going to be the white version of the black decals right there. They like to do both depending on where kind of tractor you're going to have pull it. We've got our state information here, and that's also repeated in white for you. We've got the fleet numbers here, also repeated in white. Then we've got some more modern stuff. This vehicle stops at all railroad crossings in yellow and red. All the Fruoff decals, state license plates, really nice large decal sheet for the tractor trailers out there. Not missing a thing on there. Then we'll go to the other side, start looking at all the white plastic provided with the kit. First thing you'll see in the box wrapped in its own plastic is this large glossy plastic styrene sheet. If you look in the instruction manual, that is provided for you to mount those Dorn logos on the side of the trailer. Since the side of the trailer has the posts on the outside, if you don't want your decal to lay over the posts, you can put your own placard on the side, and you'll have to custom cut this to fit those decals. So I have a bandsaw, that won't be a problem. Some of you'll have to do it with a handsaw or score it with your knife. Now, coming out from the white styrene, the largest pieces are the sides of the trailer, the exterior posts. You can see we've got our hinges for the rear doors. Pretty easy to figure out front and rear. We've got these nice holes. That's where your marker lights will usually go in, your clearance lights. And the rivet detail on those is really nice. Get that up close, let you see it. On the inside, you'll just see how it looks with those pushed out from the mold. You will be able to open the doors on this trailer. You will be able to see inside of it. So how much you want to decorate that inside is up to you. We've got our floor here, which has wood graining detail and rounded head bolts. So you will be able to detail that wood floor if you choose. I can tell you in advance, I won't be doing that. We've got the underneath. This is where our rails and our axles will mount, our frame rails, our kingpin plate. Strong trailer there. We got another long piece for the roof. Smooth on top, ribbed on bottom for reinforcement on the inside of the trailer. You can see tabs where it should help us assemble everything. What I usually do, as you'll see in this session here, is when I start doing the sides, I like to assemble it upside down and glue it together like so. Makes it a lot easier than trying to do it right side up, because we can get everything into these tabs and start gluing things together, and all the grooves, we can make everything work out. And a lot of times, you can even leave this as white styrene, one, because it's perfectly smooth, looks like gloss white paint, but also because a lot of these trailers would have a type of a plastic translucent roof to help light the trailer on the inside. So that would be correct for a lot of these on there. We've got the front of the trailer here with the exterior ribs, Fruoff logo, got our airline hookups detailed there, and the inside, of course, is the impressions from those exterior posts. Got another piece of plastic here. I think this was also used to make some of the side signs on the trailer. I don't think it's mentioned in this one because they provide that new piece of plastic. Here we've got our doors with our hinges, our locking mechanisms, and our kingpin plate. Got the frame rails for the axles. Select the point, you can see all the little holes in there. We've got part of our landing gear, mud flaps, definitely required. They'll get pulled over for those. Got our spring suspension. Got our frame for the axles. On this one, we've got the actual axles themselves with the mounts for the brakes. We've got our wheels, or the insides of our wheels. We've got our little air tank there. And finally, for the styrene in the kit, we have these sweet old style wheels. Remember, these are vintage kits. We've got the rest of our landing gear. And that is it. That's everything that's in the box for the exterior post van kit. I'm going to get to throwing glue. It takes a lot of glue for these, so we will be right back for that. Thank you. It's not very difficult to get this far. These semi-trailer builds are usually quite easy, as is this one. We've got a lot of stuff done because we're going to get it into paint. We're going to do some easy work on it. They don't go real far with these, you know, making them super detailed or anything. So what we've got is the entire trailer body assembled, roof, sides, doors. You saw me put everything together. When I put stuff on the roof, what I like to do when it's upside down, building it that way, building it from the top up, what I like to do is use super glue from the dollar store, just the cheap stuff you can find in the little red bottles. And then I use super glue activator, and I just refill this little bottle of activator from a larger bottle that you can buy. And then I use a little pipette to drip it onto those spots. That will tack weld it in place. And then I use my preferred model cement, which is Plastruct Bonding. Right there. You can get that at like modelroundup.com, has it in stock all the time for you. Then I'll use that to actually weld everything together and melt all the plastic together on large assemblies like this, where you can see it can be a little fiddly with hands and stuff getting stuff together. We've got the wheels together. I'm going to be painting over those chrome trim rings. Then I will be doing the inner wheel the same color as the trailer body to match in there, and the outer in a more generic color. That's why I did not insert this into that part yet. I want to wait, and then I will push all four of these in, and the inner wheels have the brake drums in them and all that with the steel axle posts where we can go in there. So that's why I did that, and I don't want any chrome on mine, so I just sanded off the chrome and used model cement, which is always a much stronger bond than just super glue. We've got our sliding axle release lever here. We'll get that painted with our mud flaps. We'll attach those later. We've got our axles and suspension and our air brakes, which of course, you know, chrome, you see those on all these work trucks. And then this part here is for holding the cables on the rig. So that suspension assembled easily. We saw that all on camera. I've got the downriggers with the wheels. I will also be painting the up part, and then the wheels are just supposed to slide off. I'd like them to see, I would have liked to see a molded set of wheels for each one, because that's a lot of fiddling around to change the wheels to have it stand, but 99.999999% it's just going to be standing on its own instead of having a truck attached to it. So we've got all that assembled. That went pretty easily. The trailer body itself isn't too hard to assemble. We've got a little guide area here for some hoses. We've got our landing gear glued in place. We've got the doors, which will close. I just want them a little bit open so I can get paint all the way around them. But you can see they'll open and close and stuff like that. We've got our taillight mounts and our license plate mount. And then we've got our Mansfield bar. Got our kingpin plate with the kingpin attached. and then we just go all the way around. If you want to paint the inside of your trailer, you can go right ahead and do so. You can leave it apart, you can paint it later, but I'm gonna have it all opened up like that. We're gonna get it painted up and decorated. So all I'm gonna do now, it's gonna be quite an awkward paint session, but I'm gonna get over there and get some paint on this trailer and get everything working right now.
Thank you.
Well, we need to get this recorded before it falls off its very precarious perch. Of course, these semi-trailers are nice and big. This is no exception at all. When it comes around, you can see the size of this Dorn exterior post van is well over 19 inches long. The decals look awesome. I love the little included plastic. You saw how easy that is to cut. Now you could cut it with a table saw, a mini table saw like I used. You cut it with a band saw, or you can go old school, cut it with a razor saw, or simply scribe it until it slices in half the way you want. You can decide with what tools you have, what basic equipment you have, how you want to cut it up. The axle is a select-a-point, and as you saw in the video when I was working on it, it will slide forward and back, and we can show that here. We'll get it to just go a little more forward, and now look how nice it sits on the turntable. So you can adjust it for your display, you can adjust it for the load you want it to haul, whatever you want it to look like, whatever you want it to do, you can be all set. Now I did a light weathering job on mine. What I wanted to look like was they kind of purchased a used trailer and rebranded it. So that's why the sign placards are in much better shape. That's why I like the nameplates and the unit numbers and the height sign and stuff like that are a little more modern, while the trailer itself is a little more beat up. They've got newer wheels and tires on it, and we made sure that we're meeting some more recent standards, but not quite the newest, brand newest trailers out there. Got that white top on there, made sure I gave it a little bit of dirt with the pastels, and then I took my sanding brush and sanding sponge and scrubbed it down to really subdue that. It's not nearly as strong, just what I call snow dust, rain dust on the top. That gives me the look I was going for. Did some metallic accents, added dirt along the grooves there where it would catch it from the road, and then right where it would be in front of the drive wheels and behind the truck, I wanted to dirty it up for the smoke and for the extra dirt that you would see coming off those drive wheels on the vehicles, whereas the trailer, since the axles are being moved around all the time, it'd be a much more even, not quite as noticeable dirty pattern as it would be right in the front, where you've got that fuel mixing with the dust off the drive wheels and stuff like that, making the front of the trailer, and especially the very, about the first 10, 15 feet of the trailer, getting a little more dirty than usual. So that is what I wanted to show on there. We got the black labels on this one. The doors will open. I've got mine pushed shut because I don't have any reason to display them, but you can decorate that wood bed on the inside of the trailer and do it up like that. So I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this over. That select-a-point is always pretty cool. I've got the landing gear permanently down on mine, so we can see how it looks. Got that Mansfield bar, and then the overspray that was on the landing gear and everything, I just did a very, very, very simple black on the bottom of the trailer, so that we weren't worrying about detailing that at this point. I just want to detail the exterior. When models sit around my place, this is all we see of them right here. So as long as I gave the tires a flat coat instead of sanding them, and we have it looking like we did the black coat with the orange over it for the interior of the wheels, so we got some shadows, looks like some brake dust swirling around in there and some road dust, and it looks authentic to me. It looks like something you'd actually see on the road with some new placards, new signs on it, but it's a trailer that's seen quite a few miles on the highway already. Thanks to Round 2 Models for sending this over. We've got more stuff from them coming up. I will link in the description as soon as I see the pre-order links are available. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. Thanks for your nice comments, subscriptions, questions, and I will see all of you at the next review.